Papa Shirandula, yeah, whose real name was Charles Bukeko, entertained very many Kenyans with his comedy. And that's why it was a huge shock for most Kenyans when it was announced a few days ago that he had passed on. And what's more, it was announced he had passed on from the virus, Corona. However, what his widow had to say at his funeral was very revealing. Indeed, she revealed what has been repeated right across the globe. A huge blunder, which seems to have cost very many people their lives. And it is still a modern-day mystery why no attention whatsoever has been paid to this particular very valid complaint linked to the virus. Papa Shirandula's widow said that when she asked what he had been tested for, she was told he had only been tested for COVID. She appears to be a medical professional or somebody with a lot of knowledge on what happens in hospitals. So she posed the question, why was he not tested for malaria? Why was he not tested for pneumonia? Because according to her, the virus, COVID, is manageable. But those other two can quickly take away somebody's life. So she posed the question, why was he not tested for the other two? And it is our hope and prayer that somebody will come forward very soon and answer that very critical question. But let me tell you what happened to a friend. Indeed, when this crisis was just starting, this was sometime in late March, a friend of mine went down with flu-like symptoms. They have a shop, and when I passed by the shop, the husband informed me that his wife had been taken ill, and informed me about the flu-like symptoms. I panicked. I panicked because another very similar case was still fresh on my mind, which had just unfolded a few days before in Mombasa. To cut a very long story short, my friend's doctor had to rush to that particular hospital, and he's the one who saved her. Because what happened is that immediately she landed at the hospital with flu-like symptoms, they were doing only one test. And after that test, they put the patient aside without managing anything else or without testing anything else. And the patient has to wait until the COVID test comes back before they're given any other attention. And what happens is that if the patient is suffering from something else, that something else continues to affect them and may easily cost them their lives, even as medics are waiting for the results of the single test, which is the most important. Oh yes, clearly the position is that is the most important test. All the other tests are secondary, not as important. And if we are to listen to the widow of Papa Shirandula, this is precisely what happened to the late actor. Only one test was carried out. It is assumed that the other diseases are no longer deadly or are no longer important to test. And there's also something else. If you pass on and the test comes back positive, you know the procedure. Very hurried burial. The patient is supposed to be buried as soon as possible. Now, what that means is that there's no thorough post-mortem. Which is interesting, because the Italians carried out thorough post-mortems. And their findings were mind-boggling. And of course, the World Health Organization and all leading specialists have ignored what the Italian specialists have been telling us. Let me just leave it at that. For today, let us celebrate the life of this Kenyan who really entertained us. Yeah, fare thee well, Papa Shirandula, until we meet again. Until next time, this is Chris Kumekucha.